welcome to It Takes Two. Wow. What a semi-final weekend it was. I don't know about you, but I loved it. Every second of it. There was no room for error, of course, as our famous five pulled out all the stops in a bid to make it to the Strictly final in Blackpool. Craig even dusted off his 10 paddle not once, but twice. I ask you, he was good, eh? In just a moment, I'll be talking to Alex and James, who were the first casualties, sad face. But before I do, tensions were running high on Saturday night. And as always, our cameras caught all the backstage nerves.
I'm too tired to be nervous yet, but in about an hour's time, I will be depriving myself of food due to the nerves that will be killing me for these semi-finals.
Upset that it could be the last one. James and I have spoken already this morning and he feels anxious as well.
Nothing about tonight is going to be easy, but we've come this far and you've got nothing to lose.
There's a nip in the air, but it's going to be red hot in that ballroom. Semi-final, two dances to do, and what is amazing, I haven't any idea who is going to make it to Blackpool.
Thought I would have liked the pasta a lot, but it's not really friends with me, to be honest. Can't do it.
It's good. I like the bit where you go down the stairs. That was really cool.
That was the best bit about it, Jane. The salsa. It's not my favourite one.
Five fabulous celebrities. It's going to be brilliant.
Paul's doing my shoes because I've got a poorly back and neck, so I can't kneel down.
There are some injuries. Polly's got a bad knee. I think I'm going to have to fake an injury, otherwise these guys might be getting some sympathy. I've got a really bad shoulder, yeah.
Jason! It's a nightmare, I'm telling you. Attacked, completely attacked by Jason Donovan's band.
Pressure's on now, though, because we've got
royalty.
Yeah, we've got royalty amongst
in the house.
Amongst us,
he has to do well.
I'm proud of this. Bruce and Leonardo on the wall at the BBC.
You're changing my fan and I don't think Pasha's best pleased about it, but I like this one better. Prettier.
10 minutes, darling, to showtime!
To get to Blackpool, everyone has got to just up their game. They've all been good, but they've got to become great.
You know, it ain't over till it's over. I'm not giving up.
Come on!
It's showtime. It's the semi-final. And let me tell you this, I think the semi-final is going to be great. But I'll tell you something else. It Takes Two this year, fantastic. Well done.
Please welcome Alex and James. Firstly, can I say, Alex, huge congratulations for being such a clever, brilliant girl and getting this far
Thank
in competition.
You, very much.
You have been amazing.
Thank you.
How was Saturday night for you? Two dances, were they nearly the death of you?
But, well, I mean, Saturday I was incredibly nervous. I think all of a sudden I thought, oh, no, we're in the semi-final. And I better get a grip. And then that made me completely nervous, didn't it? You could feel
in the
waltz. I think it's because it was our first dance. But then you thought, oh, gosh, and then we've got the salsa. But, I mean, the waltz was a dance that I really enjoyed learning. And I am really annoyed with myself for getting so nervous. But, you know, what can you do?
Bottom of the leaderboard, quite tricky. Were you hoping at that point that the public would save you? Do you have your fingers behind your back going, please, please, please get us the final?
Yeah, I mean, of course we did. We really did want to get to Blackpool just because it would mean we'd have another week and we could see the experience all the way through. That's the only reason. I mean, we were never going to win, were we?
No, it was never about winning.
Never about winning.
I mean, we were really happy to get to the semi-final. So whatever happened, we knew that we'd had a great experience.
Yeah.
We had fun doing it. It would have been a bonus to get to the final. But I think the three dancers that are in the final, I think that they're all fantastic.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a brilliant final.
The three finalists, I think, truly deserve to be in that final. I mean, you know, I wasn't strong enough as a dancer to be there. We would have liked to be there just to have...
We would have taken it, wouldn't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, just to have a new...
We'll have that.
In your face.
We would have had it. But, I mean, I think, you know, the right result actually, you know, took place. And I think those three people deserve to be there on Saturday.
It's been quite an incredible, I'm not going to use the word, adventure. I'm not using the J word. There we go, I stopped myself. But despite working at an incredibly hard schedule as well, doing the one show as well, you've given us so much joy, you've shown so much fun and energy. Here are your Strictly best bits, Alex.
Don't cry, James.
The one you'll be putting on a show with is James Jordan!
James is cheeky chappy, which makes the session lots of fun.
What are you doing?
She's so easy to work with.
Not bad.
She's always in a good mood. That kind of rubs off on me, because normally I'm quite a miserable person.
There was parts that were really good and parts that were nearly good.
It's lamb to the slaughterhouse.
I thought it was very starchy, I thought it was very stiff.
There's only one way to go, and that's upwards.
It's very complicated, this. I'm having problems with holes in my arms. I've been a Madame Tussauds.
Miss Jones. I had no idea you were such a glamour puss.
Controlling my nerves is becoming a real issue.
She gets in gear and it's like...
See? I'm jumping! James! It's horrible!
He's like an annoying older brother.
No! Don't say
It was simple, but it was simply beautiful.
Let's get ready to rumba.
Sexless, cold and stiff.
I think James's job is quite a lot harder this week. We had quite a knock, so the confidence isn't quite there.
You need to channel a lot of anger and aggression. And I'm going to get her to think about one person. And great, Revel Horwood.
It was the complete antithesis of last week, and I almost found it erotic.
You've had a breakthrough this week. You've upped your game.
She has difficulties doing one step, let alone 500.
Not slow step,
not
quick
slow
step.
Elegant dynamic, frissons of excitement running down my spine.
Kick me upstairs, kick me upstairs. For this week, I think it would be a good idea to have the St. John's Ambulance poise.
It was so full of verve and gusto, I thought it was terrific.
It was sharp, it was staccato, it was theatrical, intense, all of those wonderful things.
I don't want her moaning in the studio.
No, I've got a bad rib.
My hair was in my eyes. It's because of these shoes. You're lucky you haven't got a nag for a partner. So...
I love the goofiness that you put in, especially on the goofy swim, ups and down, legs in the air.
You have been consistently improving in this competition, and I think you deserve credit.
Strictly is quite an intense experience, but I literally can say, hand on heart, I have loved every single day. It's everything I thought it would be and more.
You dance beautiful, and you deserve to be in this semi-final.
The first couple leaving tonight is Alex and James.
The first time I met you, Alex, we clicked and got on really well. It's been an honour, a pleasure, a privilege, and I've enjoyed every single second, so I thank you for that.
I'd just like to say a huge thank you to James. He's become a really close friend, and to get me to the semi-finals, he deserves an absolute medal. I love him to bits, and I'll miss him.
Sparkly tissues around. James, how proud of Alex are you?
Oh, very. I mean, I honestly never thought that we would get that far, and you surprised me. I didn't think you would ever be able to dance the way you did in that semi-final, and it was fantastic, and I've enjoyed, hand on my heart. I know lots of people sit here and say, oh, yeah, I've had a wonderful experience, but it's been so much fun, and for me, that's what this show or this series has been about for me. It's not been about winning or how far can I get. I've loved every second I've spent with her. It's been brilliant.
Will you keep on dancing? Because you're such a dynamic partnership, aren't you? You two have such a laugh.
Oh, you know what? I mean, it's just been incredible. I don't know. I mean, if you want to give me a few more lessons, then you can.
Yeah, come on.
I mean, I think he's at the end of his tenth.
No, not at all.
Who are you rooting for at the weekend out of the three finalists? Who do you like to see lift the Glitter Ball trophy?
They're all great. I think anyone could genuinely lift up the trophy. For me personally, I would like to see Harry win. But if Chelsea or Jason won, they're wonderful people. But for me, I just think that Harry should win. I think he's been slightly undermarked the past few weeks. Okay. I think he's brilliant. Mm,
he's consistent and he's a nice guy.
Dry your eyes, Alex. You've got to go and work on the One Show now. But can I just say, it's been so lovely to see a whole different side to you that we don't get to see on the One Show.
No.
You have been hilarious and you've been such a joy to watch. Oh, go on, going. Alex and James!
Thank you.
Brilliant. It's so sad. In a few moments, I'll be chatting to Holly and Artem. I'm going to be in pieces by the end of the show. Who also missed out on a place in the final. But up first, with Double the Dances this weekend, there was plenty to get your tongues wagging. Here are your points if you get it together, Ball. The weekend's frocks. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night.